Hello and welcome to the Mr. Big channel. This is Jeremiah here, Mr. Big's oldest son. So basically, Mr. Big is on business, making that fresh cash. And basically, we're at home and, you know, chilling, doing our schoolwork, stuff like that. And for today, Mr. Big had a request of recording us cleaning Noah's Red Prelude. Yeah, so as you can see, it's not even that dirty. It's just very dusty. Like, they used the Bondo and I guess they left the doors open or something. And like, you could see like the red paint and the red whatever they were using over there. So Noah's currently inside and he's not able to do anything with us at the moment. But when he does come outside, we will start cleaning this thing really good for Mr. Big. As a request for him. So yeah, we're gonna get started on that. So what we're going to be using to clean this really dirty car is obviously we're going to use the trusty old shop vac to get out most of the big pieces and, you know, the dust on the seats and everything. And after that, we're just going to take a little bit of dish soap and just a huge bucket of water, and we're just going to wipe everything down, you know, the dust, the grime, the dirt, basically everything. And then after that, you know, since I cannot take out seats, once Mr. Big is back, we're gonna film some more in this car on our project. And basically, he's gonna take out all the seats, the two front ones, and maybe the carpet even, just to clean it even better. And we are probably gonna wash them really good with like Red Hot, because Red Hot does leave this like super, like, not even clean, it's like weird feeling on the seats and on the actual plastic. So we might use Red Hot or dish soap, Dawn, because Dawn helps everything, you know, gets off the grease and basically everything. So after that, we're just gonna wipe everything down, we're gonna record all of it, and we're gonna see you guys then. Peace. Quick update. So Noah's still doing homework, and basically for now these seats are like a lost cause. They're not really, it's not really what they are, but they're really dusty. Like, if you try to vacuum them, you're gonna be sitting there for like 6 hours just trying to vacuum them, and none of the dust is gonna be out. So basically what I did here was I just tried to vacuum it as best as possible. As you can see, still a whole bunch of dust lines and stuff, and when you like barely touch them, they're already super dusty. I'm still gonna do the rest of the car. As you can see, I did this. It's pretty clean actually for a Honda Prelude from the auction. I vacuumed it really nicely. I'm still gonna be dusting it also with Noah if he's ever gonna be done with his homework. But basically, once Mr. Big gets here from his work trip, we're gonna be taking out the seats. The back ones are in good condition. Like, once you vacuum them really good, there's not a lot of dust in them. You like these ones are filled with dust, but the rest of the car is just super dusty. Like, it just needs a really good wipe down, you know, with some Dawn dish soap, Red Hot, whatever. We might take out the carpets because they have like this like brown tint to them, like brown color. So we might just pressure wash them with some Red Hot, because Red Hot's good for carpets, especially these. The roof is actually not that bad considering this is a Honda Prelude. I'm gonna be cleaning that last, and yeah, we're just gonna keep on going. Give you guys an update in a bit.
3 hours later.
Hello, hello, and welcome back to the Mr. Big channel. Basically, as you can see, I got a little haircut. I got about an inch off. That was our little break from cleaning. After that, we just went to go get some food at Chick-fil-A. They have a great new sandwich. The Pimento, whatever it's called, cheese sandwich. It's really good. And basically, what's going on with the car is that before we left, I cleaned. It looks basically brand new. It just has like this weird brown, like somebody spilled on it. Something spilled on it, and they try to clean it up. This is just dirty because it's just like a plastic piece. I'm probably gonna wipe that down really good. Basically, everything is vacuumed, except nothing has been wiped down. The front seats are like a lost cause. I tried to vacuum them for like 30 minutes straight, and nothing really went as planned because I thought they were not going to be as dusty. Basically, all the Bondo just got on them, as you can see, like on the air vents. Look how dirty those are. Like, the car wasn't that. It was way cleaner before we got it back from paint. The back seats were really clean. Like, we're not even gonna have to clean them like with any sort of special cleaner. They were a little dusty, but once you vacuumed over them about like 3 or 4 times, they were good. You know, this floor had lots of stuff on it, but like I said, I vacuumed it all up, but you know, it still has like this little brown tint. Like, compare like this and then like to this. As you can see, this was pretty clean right here. So what I'm gonna go do right now is I'm gonna go move all the stuff over to that side. I'm gonna be vacuuming that side right now. After that, I'm gonna be wiping everything down with a little bit of dish soap, because dish soap helps everything. You know, it gets all the grease, all the grime, everything. The radio is still, it looks legit. Like, it looks like it would probably work as planned. This is a 1999 Civic, so it's a little better than mine. Like, everything looks a little better. Like, these controls are right here instead of being on the panel of this right here. Something was up with it right here. Like, it's broken and starting to fall off, as you can see. So we're probably gonna, we might even replace it. It's not broken, it's just really dirty, and something was moving around in there. So we're gonna get all that figured out. Noah has a little bit of homework left, so once he's gonna come out here, we're gonna introduce him if he wants to come help us out. And it's about to rain in, I don't know, an hour and a half, so gotta get as much done as today, and whatever we don't finish, we'll just finish up tomorrow. Before I started vacuuming, I also wanted to point out the trunk. So basically, when I first opened it, it was smelled like something died in here. Basically, I tried to vacuum it. Like, there was just, you see all these like bolts and little screws and everything? They were just in the middle. There was lots of like, it wasn't even like that dirty. Dirty meaning no wrappers or anything. As you can see, it was just like a whole bunch of like screws and whatnot. So basically, I left this to air out, and there was lots of moisture and water in here. Like, there was some spider webs and stuff, so I just had to vacuum it out really good. That's moldy right there. So I'm gonna have to wait until Mr. Big comes home, and we're probably just gonna deep clean this together, because I don't even know how to clean this. Like, I try to vacuum that off. I don't know if it's mold or some kind of paper or whatever, but we're just gonna have to see what's gonna happen when he gets back. All right, I am back again. So this door was more like stable than the other door, like as I showed you before. other door was kind of like wobbly. This one had like a weird like mark, like right here. See, like when you, look how dusty it is. It's really bad. So basically, this door was more stable and it was looked like a lot better than that one. As you can see, I don't really know if you can see it, but there's like this dent in the door. It looks like somebody like hit it really hard or some kind of, somebody just did something to it. But both sides of the floor have been vacuumed. I tried to vacuum the seat, but like I said, they just butchered the seats. Like the seats have inhaled dust and it's, you have to just take them out and pressure wash them with some Red Hot. But like I said, there's this really weird tint to the floor. I have vacuumed everything. The actual carpet is really clean. The back carpet's also really clean. Basically the actual vacuuming part. These seat belts were clean. They just were really dusty, just had to vacuum them. This part I will wipe down because they're super dirty. The back seats were basically brand new. Like there was there was a little bit of dust on them, but the back seats, like you can tell that they were rarely used. There's the license plate and the little frame for the license plate, but right now I will probably just leave the vacuum out just in case. And I'm gonna get to wiping down and I will show you guys what it looks like when I'm completely done.
2,000 years later.
Alright, so as you guys can see, I have completely detailed this car. Not really completely, like I have left out like the windows. It really looks like it's about to start thundering like crazy. That's not why I stopped. Actually, right when it started looking like this, I finished up everything that I needed to finish. So basically, if you hop inside, I'm not going to. I completely got rid of like every single speck of dust. Like you can tell that it looks pretty brand new. Like just somebody sold it off of OfferUp to you. OfferUp, you know, they cleaned it really good. Obviously the floor is, like I said, tinted brown and it's looks nasty. Like, you know, I cleaned all this. This thing was really dirty, I had to clean that. Seat belts, I finally got all the Bondo off. They still have, yeah, see, that's not coming off. The back, I wiped down all the plastic with some Dawn dish soap. License plate, what else? Basically, the panels look brand new, except this one's kind of messed up. See, like, it has this little thing, whatever it's called. The dirtiest part about this car was definitely the door jams. The door jams were insanely dirty. I wiped down those. I had to change my water like 3 times. But I think this is where we're gonna end on this video. Noah didn't really help, but that's alright. He couldn't really help with much anyway, so we're just gonna end on this note, you know, with the done car. Everything's clean about it, you know. So since we're ending the video and Mr. Big's not here, on behalf of Mr. Big, I know that he would want me to say something like, you know, subscribe, like, and share. So remember to subscribe, like, share, turn on the bell for to get notifications about our new videos. We do have a surprise project behind the car, behind the house, which we're going to be working on in the next couple videos once Mr. Big comes back. So everybody have a good day. Yeah. Thank you for Mr. Big for giving me something to do at home, you know? Peace.